Hello, welcome to this video dedicated to Google Blogger, one of the best online platforms for blogs since 1999. Whether you're a beginner or an expert, Blogger offers a user-friendly experience to build posts, pages, and manage content without any knowledge on coding. In just 13 minutes, we are going to see everything you need to know to build a complete blog from scratch with the powerful support of ChatGPT. To get started, open the main Blogger page and log in with your Google account. At this point, go to Create Your Blog and define title or name for the blog and its custom URL address. This gets a blogspot domain and your own custom subdomain. Jump to the end of this video to see how to link your blog to your own domain. Once done, your blog is live with its complete address you can test with your browser. This gets a default layout, title, an empty place for your future posts, and your user profile on the left. You can also preview your site by going to View Blog on the left side of the dashboard. This also lists several options you can use to edit and manage your blog. Let's start writing a post. Click on New Post and type any title or name on top, and then its body content at the bottom. You can also copy and paste text inside if you have the article ready. To augment your work, you may get AI support from ChatGPT. In an article dedicated to roses, you may send a prompt asking to write a first draft with a proper perspective, such as an expert gardener. Main content, the rose varieties, style to use, friendly, and blog audience, medium user. You can copy and paste the result inside your post and edit it to fit your own style and add your own experience. While ChatGPT can be helpful to get hints and ideas, it's essential not to rely excessively on it, as mistakes may easily occur. You can also get tips on how to make a cool title, especially good for search rankings. Now let's see how to edit and customize the post content with the buttons on top. Select any piece of text and go to Font Type to change font family, and adjust the font size as you need. If you do not select any text, no modifications will be done. You can also apply several paragraph, P tag or heading styles, H tags, and use the undo redo buttons to go through your actions made. Set text style, background color, and fill color, and add hyperlinks by selecting any text and clicking on the link button. Define the destination address and some options such as opening the link in a new browser tab or enabling the nofollow attribute to prevent search engines to take such link into account. Go to Insert Image to add images from your local computer or any URL provided. Once done, set the image alignment, size, and add captions and alt attributes if necessary. To import videos, go to Insert Video and either upload a video from your computer or paste a YouTube link. You can also add emojis. Set paragraph alignment and indentation. Add outstanding bulleted or numbering lists. Set pieces of quotes. And apply horizontal separators. On Input Tools, choose the language for your post. Once ready, you can save and preview your post in the top right corner. You can check your blog through a desktop, a tablet, or a smartphone view. On the right, you can adjust various post settings, add labels or tags to find your post on searches or on the internet, change the publication date, apply a custom post address known as a permalink, and manage the comments permissions properly. If everything is good, click on Publish to make your post live. This will also get listed under the Posts section. When writing your post, Blogger shows the editor in Compose view, but you can switch to HTML view if you prefer to work with the HTML code, including its attributes, links, and styles. Also, in this case, ChatGPT can really help. In the prompt, specify code language, HTML, and any formatting or style if you want to generate a CSS file. You can copy and paste the result and start from it to build your posts as you like. Now, let's see how to manage the blog layout. By default, your main page shows the list of your posts as page body, with the latest and bigger article as featured post. To customize this layout, go to Layout on the left side of the dashboard. Here you get several elements in bold to edit, each with a bunch of gadgets inside. For instance, you can take the sidebar top in order to hide your blogger profile from your blog, or change the order of its gadgets listed. Make sure to save your changes to get a quick preview of the result. You can also add gadgets within any element. For example, to add AdSense banners, custom HTML codes, search bars, and much more. You can also hide or show the header element, set title and description, or upload an image as background below its text. On Featured Post, you can show or hide its title, abstract, or thumbnail. On Page Body, you set the number of posts and comments to show, and on Footer, you can add attributions and copyright notices at the bottom of the page. Let's understand how to customize the post appearance. This is set by a theme template that you can change and manage from Theme on the left. A default theme is already applied on top, but you can pick another by browsing through the list below. Each theme comes with its unique colors, appearance, and layout for your blog. To edit the chosen theme, click on Customize and move through the options on the left. On Background Image, you can import your favorite image to use as background for your blog and change the main color theme to apply on text, menus, and buttons according to the theme type selected. Go to Advanced to edit several elements you can choose on top in order to change height, background color, transparency, and even the font style for your posts. Make sure to click on the Save button in the bottom right corner to apply all your modifications. On Customize, you can make a backup of your theme setup or revert it to the original one. You can also go to Edit HTML to modify its code as you need. Now let's talk about creating and managing pages. By default, you just have the main home page, but you can create others by going to the Pages section and then to New Page. Just like any post, set the title and add content with either the Compose or the HTML view. When you go to Publish, the page is available online and listed in your Pages section. But it won't be accessible on your blog automatically. To do so, you have to share the page address, such as permalink, through a hyperlink or a menu, as we're going to see. To create a menu, open the Layout section on the right and go to Page List. Set the menu name and click on Add Item to add an item with title and proper link, for example, one per each page. This way, your blog will get a complete and organized menu. On the left, Blogger shows other options to manage your blog. On Stats, you access analytics about your blog performance. On Comments, you manage and review comments left. And on Earnings, you can connect AdSense and check your monetization status. On Settings, adjust blog title, description, and language, and enable warnings about any adult content. You can also add your Google Analytics ID to get insights into your traffic and views, and go to Favicon to customize the icon appearing on the browser tabs. Make sure to clear your cache if you do not see it applied. You can also hide or show your blog from search engines, especially if it is still in progress. Apply any HTTPS protocol, manage permissions, set how many posts to show on your main home page, and add any custom CSS file as post templates. On formatting, set time zone and date format, and add meta tags to improve your blog index on search engines, separated by commas. You can also edit display messages if errors occur, complete with redirects to other blog pages. On monetization, you can upload any ads.txt file for AdSense and go to Manage Blog to make a backup of your entire blog or even delete it. Blogger can also host a custom domain for your blog, purchased from Google or elsewhere. To connect your domain, go to Settings, Publishing, and take a note on the two CNAME records that you have to add in your domain panel. After waiting 24 hours, the connection with your domain is done. To make a complete redirect to your blog, you may also add 4 Google A records as well, removing any existing A record from your domain panel. Take a look at our video description to learn more on how to make a correct redirect. Thank you very much for watching this tutorial. Make sure to visit our YouTube channel and our official website for more hints, tips, and giveaways completely for free.